Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Let's talk about semiochemical agents. These are one of the many biological agents which are being used in biotechnology, especially to control pests and insects. Now, semiochemical agents are natural messenger substances which influence growth, development, or behavior in numerous plant and animal species. For example, pheromones. Pheromones are the natural chemical substances which are released by so many living organisms, almost all of them. And these pheromones, they work as messenger to deliver certain message to other living organisms. For example, these messages can repel two organisms away from each other, or these messages can attract two organisms towards each other. So these pheromones have been widely used in biotechnology, and these facts have been so much manipulated and exploited in biotechnology to achieve certain results. For example, if you want to repel certain pests, certain insects from certain crop, we can use repellent. Or in other case, what we can do is that we can use the attractant pheromone, but we can use it away from the crop. So the insect will be diverted away from the crop towards the attractive pheromone. So this has been successfully applied to control various forms of insect pests, either directly to divert them from crops and trap them. Directly kaise apply kar sakte hain hum ki hum unko crop se divert karke kisi aur janib le jaye aur unko kisi aur janib attract ho jaye due to the pheromones present there, and there we can trap them in certain trap. So what we are doing is we are not only trying to save the crop here, but we are also trying to capture those insects. So this is a direct approach. Or indirectly to trap their natural enemies in large numbers for introduction into the fields for defense. Agar hum ye approach nahi kar sakte, the other approach, which is called indirect approach, is that we can trap the enemies of those insects. And again, we can use the pheromones to attract them. If we have captured the enemies, the predators of those insects, we can introduce those captured predators in the ecosystem, in that area where the insects are causing problems. So what we are doing here is that we are trying to kill those insects which are causing problem to the crops indirectly by introducing the predators. So predators are now killing the insects. In the end, the crop is secured. So you can see here these types of chemical agents can be used by so many different ways and means. There are so many different examples as well, which we will cover in next lessons.